Good evening. First tonight, hundreds of residents at a Maribyrnong apartment complex are entering the first of 2 weeks in lockdown after their building was exposed to the virus by a furniture removal crew from Sydney. They were given little notice and many learned of their lockdown from the media before public health crews took control of the situation.
The apartment complex is named after the Lion of God, but there was no divine intervention, just a letter ordering residents into isolation.
Saw a letter on my front door, didn't read it, just put it in my handbag and drove out the car park and saw all the news crews and thought, OK, something must be up.
Others got a shock from the media.
My roommate put it on the fridge late in the night, so I didn't see it.
Cheryl Scott is one of dozens who woke to orders to call contact tracers and told not to leave, even for vaccinations.
It was like, OK, I don't get any notice. This is it. I'm stuck here now for 14 days. It would have been good to have a little bit more notice.
More than 100 left to get tested.
I'd just like to show my boss that I'm actually going to get tested and this is all real, that I'm not just taking a day off from work.
Once they left, they were given a fast pass at the showgrounds as health officials expressed frustration over the interstate incursion.
The gang of three removalists from Sydney who went on a fairly long road trip from Sydney.
I was definitely around the furniture, if not the removalist.
They left Sydney, worked in the apartment last Thursday, then headed west for the border, generating exposure at a petrol station in more ways than one.
And this includes the shower facilities, as one of the known positive cases had a shower there.
Immediately following today's Victorian COVID news conference, the response commander Jerome Weimar came down to this Maribyrnong tower to lead the public health teams and understand residents' concerns.
Obviously, I understand there may well have been a small number of people who didn't get that messaging in the early hours when they went out to work. We'll be picking up with them during the course of the day and make sure they come back into isolation.
That's despite this morning's assurance from the Premier.
We're very confident that we've got our arms around that and those people are in ISO and they've been doing the right thing.
A hard order to prevent another major outbreak. Simon Love for 10 News First.
And Simon Love joins us live now. Simon, are there other exposure sites?
There are, Candice. These relate to a family of four which returned to Victoria from New South Wales on red zone permits and were to be in isolation. But they did, members of that family did visit a Coles in Craigieburn at the Craigieburn Central Shopping Centre as well. Metro Petroleum in Broadmeadows. So they have been listed as exposure sites with various dates and times and also requirements for those that had been there at those times. Now, these visits occurred when the family were supposed to be in isolation. That's really the biggest concern for authorities at the moment, is making sure those returning from New South Wales on red zone permits are actually following those orders, following the rules, remaining in isolation. We did hear of another two people today that were found not to be following those red zone permits. Now, Candice, as for these interstate incursions and what it means for restrictions in Victoria, well, the acting chief health officer says there's no need to be concerned at the moment, but it means that perhaps the next easing of restrictions due on July 21 may need to be pushed back a little bit more.
Okay, thank you, Simon.